We have now a very simple form. We can save the values at once because we wrap those fields inside a form. And instead of using a basic text field widget, we change it to text form field, which provides some additional features. Now it would be nice to validate the form before we save it, before we read the values and before we do something with those values. We need to be sure that the values are correct, and this is the validation. So in this episode, I will show you a very simple validation in Flutter. The text form field widget provides a validator parameter, which also accepts a function. And this function, similar to onSaved, takes a one parameter, and the parameter is the value that's being typed inside the field. And now we can check if this value corresponds to certain rules. So let's start with the to field, which is an email. We will start with something simple, first man validation, email validation, which is we will take the value and we will just check if it contains the ampersand sign. So if it contains, let's negate that for convenience. So if it doesn't contain the ampersand, we will display a text saying that to must be a valid email. And otherwise, we will return null. Now we have the validation in place. We defined the rule, the constraint for the value of this particular field. Now we have to trigger the validation. And this happens when someone clicks the send button. So before saving, we need to check all the values from the form correspond to the criteria we defined for those values. So for this, we will use again a current state, and there is another method called validate. First, we validate, and if the form is okay, which means that if the validator functions we defined for each field pass, then save the form and do the regular work. If it's not, stop on the screen and display the message that something is wrong. So now, if I type something here, which doesn't contain the ampersand, I'm getting the validation message. It works. We can define other validations. So we, for example, here or for the subject, we can say that the user should let's use a longer function. So we will say if, or maybe if len equals 0, then return cannot be empty, else if. Subject must be longer than 4 characters, and otherwise return null, which means that it's okay. First, if the value is not specified, I'm getting subject cannot be empty, and if I just type 3 characters, I'm getting another message. If the subject is longer, the message disappears. So this way you can define your validations for each field, and then thanks to a form container, we can trigger validate. We can validate the form at once, which means that Flutter behind the scenes will execute each function that's defined for the validator parameter, which is very similar to how onSaved works. So In this case, we first validate the form to see if the values are correct, if they correspond to the rules, to the validations we set for them. And if they do, we save the form and then we continue with our regular flow of execution. Usually you don't define the validations by hand, but you rely on some libraries that are already built. So one of them I found just the first that came up is email validator, and we can include that. And there is a method, like a proper way of validating an email. The rules are pretty complex, and using such libraries, it's faster and easier. It's the proper way of doing that. If you are validating email or any other more complex situation, first try to find an existing library, and then if it doesn't work, if you cannot find one, define your validation as we did here. That's all for today, and see you in the next episode.